We had seen this diagram of mechanism of HCl secretion and another one on regulation of secretion of acid in another video. But HCl is an acid and gastric mucosa needs to be protected of its harmful effect. So what are these mechanisms? So here this diagram is showing these glands which are dipping into the mucosa, and then beneath the mucosa there is submucosa. Top it is showing the lumen. We know that there are various cells which line the gastric mucosa. There is surface epithelial cells, mucus neck cells, then there are HCl secreting cells at the base and the chief cells which secrete pepsinogen. Surface epithelial cells and mucus neck cells secrete mucus which forms a viscous layer in the lumen of the stomach. This viscous layer is approximately 1 millimeter thick. Also, we have seen that if HCl secretion, bicarbonate goes into the blood, that is known as alkaline tide. The bicarbonate, as it passes through the blood, it is captured via these surface epithelial cells which secrete this bicarbonate into the gastric lumen. So this forms a mucus bicarbonate layer in the gastric lumen. Because of this layer, there is a gradient of pH at the surface. That means as HCl is being secreted, it comes to the top. At the top of this layer, the pH is around 1 to 2. But because of the mucus and bicarbonate, slowly the pH increases along this layer, and at the surface, pH is approximately 7. Now that means the secreted HCl will not be able to harm the mucosa. But in case it manages to corrode epithelial layer, nearby epithelial cells rapidly migrate to the site of the injury and cover it. This process is known as restitution. Thus, there are layers of protection. Pre-epithelial formed by the mucus bicarbonate layer, epithelial layer where epithelial cells are secreting this mucus bicarbonate and they can perform restitution. Plus, there is sub-epithelial protection due to the blood flow. Now, all these layers of protection are enhanced by prostaglandins I2 and E2. They are type of prostaglandins which are released by these surface epithelial cells themselves. So these prostaglandins stimulate the secretion of mucus, stimulate the secretion of bicarbonate, they increase the ability of the cells for restitution, they also increase the submucosal blood flow. So the secretion of these prostaglandins is very important for maintaining gastric mucosal defense. Even then, in spite of all these preventive mechanisms, ulceration does occur in gastric mucosa as well as in duodenal mucosa. These ulcers caused due to imbalance in HCl secretion and protective mechanisms is known as peptic ulcer. So this peptic ulcer can be due to excess secretion of acid or due to diminished defense mechanisms or maybe both. Both the factors, that is excess H plus secretion and diminished mucosal defense, occur in H. pylori infection. Now this bacteria has the ability to dig deep into the mucus layer and survive there. Because of this, there is continuous inflammation in the gastric mucosa and also the defense mechanisms are decreased as it is invading the mucus bicarbonate layer. Now diminished mucosal defenses occur by a group of drugs known as NSAIDs. That is non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. These are some anti-inflammatory drugs very commonly used. These drugs inhibit COX enzyme, cyclooxygenase enzyme. Now this enzyme is responsible for formation of prostaglandin I2 and E2. And as we have seen how these prostaglandins are essential for maintenance of mucosal defense mechanism. In peptic ulcer, the gastric mucosa gets corroded and there is ulcer formation. This leads to severe pain in epigastric region. This pain has a tendency to be relieved by food because food buffers some acid in the stomach. So, the peptic ulcer pain is relieved by food. But if this ulceration keeps on progressing, it can even lead to perforation because the ulcer will extend into the various layers of the stomach lining. So how to treat this peptic ulcer? Since these two are the mechanisms of development of peptic ulcer, a drug should also act to correct these two processes. So there are drugs which decrease acid secretion and there are drugs which improve mucosal defense. Now the drugs which decrease acid secretion, they can act on various levels. They can block the action of vagus on these cells, or they can block the action of gastrin on enterochromaffin-like cells on paritis cells. But you see, the drugs which will be most effective will be those that act on lower levels of secretion. So the drugs which decrease the effect of histamine secreted from ECL cells will be very effective, since histamine is secreted due to the effect of vagus and gastrin also. So these drugs that block the action of histamine on parietal cells are H2 receptor antagonists. We have seen in a discussion of parietal cells that parietal cells have these H2 receptors where histamine can stimulate the secretion of HCl. So H2 receptor antagonists will block the effect of histamine on stimulation of HCl secretion. If you block at upper levels, alternate pathways of activation of parietal cells are still intact. So suppose the release of gastrin is inhibited, even then vagus can stimulate its ECL cells which are acting on parietal cells. Now you may ask that even after inhibition of effect of histamine, gastrin and vagus are still able to parietal cells. True. That is why histamine receptor antagonists are not the most potent drugs to reduce HCl secretion. The most potent drug for inhibiting HCl secretion are hydrogen potassium ATPase inhibitor. So we have seen that hydrogen potassium ATPase pump is the one which is secreting H plus ions. So there are drugs which block the action of these drugs. These are known as PPIs, proton pump inhibitors. So drugs which decrease HCl secretion are H2 receptor antagonists and proton pump inhibitors. Now there are drugs which increase mucosal defense. One of the drug is sucralfate. This drug binds with acid and forms a viscous paste that adheres selectively to ulcer base and prevents further damage of the injured area. Then there are other drugs, bismuth compounds. The mechanism of action of these drugs is not much known, but they increase mucosal defense. Then there are prostaglandin analogs. We have seen that how prostaglandin is so efficient in maintaining the gastric mucosal barriers. Now these prostaglandin analogs are especially successful if NSAIDs are given chronically. Since NSAIDs are blocking the production of prostaglandin, so along with NSAIDs, if we give prostaglandin analogs, then it maintains the mucosal defense.